Hey guys, so it's Madeline Rebecca here. People in my apartment are literally driving down with the motorcycle back and forth. Anyway, not my problem. It's the lighting that I care about, so we're gonna stay here. But it's Madeline Rebecca. I'm back with a new video. I just got off work, so it's a Friday night. I'm gonna hang out with my friends, you know, the usual stuff. Figured I'd make a quick video. Like and subscribe for more. As I've said, I'm trying to find my style. Comment below ideas and let's talk. So I always talk about like favorite memories and stuff like that. And I figured on my channel, you guys should get to know me more. And my favorite memory is whenever I met Maroon 5. And I feel like I've never like fully explained that story. I always just say it. And if you guys are gonna get to know me more, it's probably better that you know the full story. So story time with me. So it was in 2013. It was just a normal night. We had Maroon 5 tickets, but they were VIP, but it wasn't like a meet and greet kind of thing. It was in row 15, which was still pretty good. Honestly, like we weren't in the very front, but we were by people that like, if you're like a concert goer, you might know this, but like if you're by people in the very back, usually the people that don't spend that much money, like just wanna be there, love the band. So if you're like, if you're at the very top, usually not, you know, those are the people that just wanted to go there, drink, hang out with their friends. But if you're in that middle section, you're with the people that truly love the band and don't have a bunch of money, but like they wanna be there no matter what. If you're in the very front, which I never knew this, but if you're in the very front, you're kind of by the people that just have money and don't really care and just, you know, oh yeah, we're just gonna be up here. Which I figured that out on my second Maroon 5 concert. I figured that out because my mom actually bought us third row tickets and they ended up, like it wasn't fun. Like nobody was screaming, nobody was like singing at all. They just had their alcohol. It just really threw me off. Anyway, back to this. So it was my first Maroon 5 concert. I was very happy with where my seats were now that I look back on it. And we were, you know, I'm a concert fanatic, so I showed up like 7 hours early, 5 hours early, somewhere around that range, and just waited for the band. If you're gonna go to a concert, you're gonna do it right with me. So I waited and waited, and you know, we walked around Nashville a little bit, and we ran into this girl once we got, like, we were waiting in, like, I think there was like this little area in Bridgestone. It was like in the front. They were like selling stuff. I don't know. Anyway, you could hang out in this area. You weren't actually in the arena yet. And she was like, hey, like you should go apply to meet them. You know, like there's a place where you can ride it, you know, go ahead and go. So we went to go apply, but you couldn't be a certain age. Like I think we were too young. So, cause it was in a bar. Yes, it was in a bar across the street. So they told us to go apply to meet them and see if we'd win. Well, we were too young. So my mom and dad were like, you know, I was calling them and they weren't even down there yet. It was me and my best friend and we were just sitting there and they were in the hotel. We were like, hey, please get down here. We need you to go to this bar. So they rush over there. They go to the bar and they fill it out. You know, we didn't think anything of it. So we're getting in line, you know, I'm still hours early and we're waiting. And apparently you had to wait at like right in front of the bar, which was like right across the street from the arena, but still it wasn't enough. So you had to wait there to see if you won. But like I said, I'm crazy, so I need to be in line. So me and my mom and my best friend were sitting there in line and my dad decided to wait. So they ended up calling names and the first thing they called, I don't know what it was, but they weren't there. But you know, my dad didn't know that at the time. So we started to walk away and they were like, hey, you know, that person's not here, we're gonna call another name. So they ended up calling another name and it was my mom and my dad called us, was like, you guys need to come in because we had already gotten through the gate. We were actually in line to get a t-shirt. So I had already given up at this point. I didn't think anything. So my dad calls my mom, was like, you guys need to get here right now. So we dropped everything. We ran outside. I literally knocked down a table. I'm not kidding. Like I full sprinted and we ended up winning. And they gave my mom the tickets technically, but then she ended up giving it to me and my best friend. And so I was on cloud nine. I mean, I was crying. They were taking our pictures. That is the best thing that's ever happened to me in the whole world. And so we wait with the people because there's some people that had like won the ticket somewhere else too. So we're waiting with like a group of people, I'd say maybe 5, 6. And they take us inside the arena in a special kind of elevator. And there is this guy. And since I'm a Maroon 5 fanatic, I know their manager and it is their manager and I'm just so freaking happy. And so like, I know who he is and I'm just talking to him and like that was a starstruck moment enough for me. So then we go down the elevator and we wait in this room and you know, they say don't touch them no matter what, because I guess shows before somebody touched him and then Adam got sick. So they said, don't touch Adam, don't touch anyone in the band. So I'm sitting here, you know, like, I want to touch James' hair. Like, I literally am just so, I'm just so excited. So they come in the room. Oh, like, they literally, you don't think that famous people are real. Like, it's so weird to me to breathe the same air as them in a concert venue. Like, I'm telling you, I'm that kind of girl. So, like, they were just real, and they all, like, just stood in a line, and we took our turn taking pictures with them. And whenever I got up to them, I just said, oh my god, you're Maroon 5. Because that's a thing that I do. Whenever I'm nervous, I state the obvious. I met Andy Grammer. I said, oh my god, you're Andy Grammer. Every single famous person I've met, I've done that. So I'm sitting there and I meet them. I say, oh my gosh, you're Maroon 5. I don't even remember saying my name. I have no idea what I said. I know I told them that I loved them. I took a picture. I sadly didn't get to touch them, but people after us did put their arms around them because I guess they just didn't listen to the rules. I'm a rule follower, okay? But I sat there and I was like, and I'll insert the picture here. But yeah, then I got to meet them, and then we left, and I was just so starstruck, and then we went back to our spots, and like I said, the atmosphere was just so great. Everyone loved the band. Everyone loved hearing that we just met them. Nobody was mad. Nobody was like, oh, well, we could have bought, you know, like, there was nothing like that. And then the concert was great, and he pointed at me, and oh my gosh, that's just literally March 24th, 2013, the best experience ever. So that's my story time. I hope you guys liked it. I will be back next week, and have a great week. Bye.